Hi everyone, welcome to MyMax Academy. In this video, we'll continue with the chapter Determinants, which is chapter 4 from your 12th standard CBSE Mathematics. We will continue from exercise 4.2 in page number 121 of your textbook. Exercise 4.2. Problem number 13, which is prove that value of this determinant equal to 1 plus a square plus b square the whole cube. You have to show that value of this is equal to this. Right? So, a solution is, so again, first thing that we try to see is whether we can get, you know, a particular row or particular column with the same elements by adding the rows or adding the columns. So, if I add all the rows, these three rows, you get 1 plus a square minus b square plus 2ab plus 2b. If you add all this, you will get 1 minus a square plus b square. So, they don't come the same. I mean, you don't get the same element when you add all the three rows, or for that matter, if you add all these three columns, you don't get the same. Or if you add all these three, you get 1 plus a square minus b square plus 2ab, 2b. If you add all this, you will get minus 2ab plus 1 minus a square plus b square minus 2a. Here you have 2b. So, they don't match. Fine. So, now we'll have to see whether we can do any other row or column operation so that we can, we'll try to check whether we can get 1 plus a square plus b square if you do some row operation, so that we can take that out if it comes. So, suppose if you observe this and this, I have 1 plus a square minus b square. This has 2b. Now, suppose if I multiply this with b, and then if I add this to this, so if I multiply this with b, it will become 2b square. 2b square, if it is added with minus b square, it will become plus b square. So, you will get 1 plus a square plus b square. So, we can try that operation. So, the operation is what? R1 implies R1 plus b times R3. I am going to multiply each element of R3 with b, and I am going to add with the row 1. So, similarly, if I observe R2, so here also, if I take this element, 1 minus a square plus b square, the row 2, I am focusing on this because I want 1 plus a square plus b square. So this, if I multiply this with minus a, if I multiply minus 2a with minus a, it will become plus 2a square. If I add plus 2a square with minus a square, I get plus a square. So this term will also become 1 plus a square plus b square. So, in the R2, we can apply the row operations R2 minus A times R3. Now, if you do this, so what is our LHS will become? Our left hand side, this will become, R1 is getting changed. So, it will become 1 plus A square minus B square plus B into R3. B into R3 is 2B. 2B into B. Your R3 is 2B. So, B into 2B is 2B square. 2B square plus this whole thing will give you 1 plus a square plus b square. Now again take this 2ab plus b times minus 2a. B times minus 2a will give you minus 2ab. This is 2ab minus 2ab. This will become 0. Then again here minus 2b plus b into this. So b into, I am writing this 1 minus a square minus b square. Fine. So now even if you simplify this, you will see if you take b common or minus b common, you will get 1 plus a square plus b square. That we will do it in the next step. Now again this row 2 is this 2ab minus a times this will give you 0. Then 1 minus a square plus b square minus a times minus 2a. Minus a times minus 2a will give you plus 2a square. Plus 2a square minus a square is plus a square. You will get 1 plus a square plus b square. Now 2a into this will give you 2a minus a into 2a, which is R2, minus a into this one, 1 minus a square minus b square. And third row, no change, right? We'll write as it is. 2b minus 2a, 1 minus a square minus b square. So, that is equal to. Now, again here, if you simplify this, you get 1 plus a square plus b square, 0. Then here, if I take my b common, if I simplify this by taking b common, I'm doing the simplification here, right? Or I can do it here, so that's fine. It will become minus 2 plus 1 minus a square minus b square. and this will be 0, 1 plus a square plus b square, and this, if I take a common here, right, so if I take, sorry, minus b common here, I will get plus 2 minus 1 plus a plus b square, if I take minus b common, right. So here if I take a common, I will get 2 minus 1 plus a square plus b square, then this is 2b minus 2a, 1 minus a square minus b square. Now, if you observe this, this is 1 plus a square plus b square, and this is what? 2 minus 1 is also 1. So, this will also become 1 plus a square plus b square. The value of this will become 1 plus a square plus b square. So, similarly here, we have 1 plus a square plus b square. This is 2 minus 1 is 1. Again, we have 1, 2 minus 1 is 1. So, 1 plus a square plus b square. So, if you see row 1, we see that 1 plus a square plus b square is present here. Here also it is there. Whenever 0 is there, then 0 can be written as 0 into 1 plus a square plus b square. So, what 1 plus a square plus b square is present in this element of row 1, in this element, as well as this is also 1 plus a square plus b square, if you simplify this. So, that can be taken out of the determinant. So, you will get 1 plus a square plus b square. Then again, if you watch this, so this is 0, this is 1 plus a square plus b square. And here also, this is 1 plus a square plus b square. So, in the second row also, we have 1 plus a square plus b square common. It is here, here, as well as here, because whenever 0 is there, then 0 can be written as 0 into 1 plus a square plus b square. So, which means a square plus b square is here, here and here. So, that cannot be again taken out. So, one more 1 plus a square plus b square will come. Then, your first row, after taking this out of the determinant, this will become 1, 0, this will become minus b. Then this will become 0, this will become 1 because we have taken this out, this will become a. Then here it will become 2b, this is minus 2a, this is 1 minus a square minus b square. Fine. So, continuation of this is equal to 1 plus a square plus b square into 1 plus a square plus b square become 1 plus a square plus b square the whole square. Okay? Multiplying these two. Now, we can see if we can further make anything 0. If not, we can even expand here itself. So, if you try to expand through, suppose row 1. So, if I expand this, this become 1 into, right? So, 1 into, 1 this into this, 1 into this. So, 1 into this into this, because we have to close this, we have to close this. So, 1 into this is 1 minus a square, 1 minus a square minus b square, that is 1 into this, minus minus 2a into a, minus minus 2 into a is minus 2a square, close, then 0 into anything will give you 0, 0, if I take this element, then this will go, so it will become minus 0, then the third element is minus b, into, if I take this, I have to close this and this, 0 into minus 3a is 0, minus 2 into b is minus 2b, it will be minus 2b. So, what will get here? So, it will become 1 plus a square plus b square the whole square into 1 minus a square minus b square plus 2a square plus 2b square. So, it will become 1 plus a square plus b square the whole square into 1 plus a square plus b square, because the value of this is minus a square plus 2a square is a square minus b square plus 2b square is b square. So, you get 1 plus a square plus b square the whole cube. This is square into this is 1, right, which is your RHS. So, that's a proof. Clear? So, we started with this and we started with the LHS. And to the LHS, which is this, we applied this row operations and then we took things common and we got this. Fine. So, all of you can pause the video, take the notes. I will go to the next problem, which is problem number 14. Prove that we have to show that determinant a square plus 1 AB AC, and this is again AB, B square plus 1, BC, then CA, CB, C square plus 1 equal to 1 plus A square plus B square plus C square. We have to show that the value of this determinant is equal to this. So again, we will try to generally try to, you know, see if we can add all the rows or any two rows to see whether we get the same element. Doesn't work, doesn't come. We don't get the same element. If you add all the three, they don't match. Or if you add column wise also, it doesn't match. So adding row or adding column doesn't work. But then let's try to see if we can somehow make this as 1 plus A square plus B square plus C square somehow here. Right? So what we can do is, if you observe here in the solution LHS, suppose in the first row, if you take A common, fine, if you take A common from the first row, this has A, this has A, this does not have A, but still I can take A common, because if you take A common from the first row, this A square will become A and 1 will become 1 by A, because I have taken A out. So if you multiply A into A is A square, A into 1 by A is 1, you will get this. Again, here if I take A common, I'll have B, here if I take A common, I'll get C. From the second row, I'm going to take B common. Then this will become A, this will become B plus 1 by B in C. From the third row, I'm going to take C common. I'll get A, B, C plus 1 by C. Right? Now again, we will try to see if adding all this works. If I add all this, I'll get 3A plus 1 by A, 3B plus 1 by B, 3C plus 1 by C. No, if I add this, I'll get A plus B plus C plus 1 by A. Here, I'll get A plus B plus C plus 1 by B. So that also doesn't help. So adding again rows or columns. After taking common, I try to add all the three rows or even two rows, we can check. Either two rows or three rows. If you add all the elements, we have to get at least the same element in a particular row or column. Then we can take that out and we can simplify. That doesn't work in this problem. Now, so is there somehow we can make this as A square, B square, C square and all that? Because we need A square. So now again, I'm going to multiply the first column element with A. This A I'm going to take inside, but now I'm going to put it on the column. So this A will become A square, A into A square plus A into 1 by A is 1. And A into A is A square, A into A is A square. So you can multiply a particular row, one row or one column with an element outside the determinant that can be taken inside, means it will go to only one row, all the elements, or only one column, all the elements. It cannot go to this. Again, you cannot multiply this A with all this. Again, A with this. It either goes to only one column or only one row. But it applies to all the elements in one row or one column. Again, here, this can go to the second column. I am going to multiply the second column with B. Then I'll get B square. Then B square plus 1. B square. Then again, this with the third column. And I get C square, C square, C square plus 1. Right? Now, this is better than this form. This form is better than this form. Now, again, we will try to check whether we can add all these three. If I add all row, I'll get 3A square plus 1. Here, 3B square plus 1. And they don't match. Now, if I add all the columns, A square plus 1 plus B square plus C square will give me 1 plus A square plus B square plus C square. Here also 1 plus A square plus C square plus B square. If I add all the three, here also I get 1 plus A square plus B square plus C square. So which means adding the column wise is helping. So which means C1 implies C1 plus C2 plus C3. If we apply this operation, then you get here 1 plus A square plus B square plus C square. Right? Again, if you add all these three, you'll get 1 plus A square plus B square plus C square. 1 plus A square plus B square plus C square. Now the second column, no change, which is B square plus 1, B square. Third column is C square, C square, C square plus 1. Now again, here we now observe that the column 1 has 1 plus A square plus B square common, so which can be taken out of the integral. You get 1, can be taken out of the determinants. A square plus B square plus C square. Sorry, I was teaching integrals the class before this for my students. So I'm still in the integral mode. I'm sorry for that. So I'm taking 1 plus a square plus b square out of the determinant, not out of the integral. I'm sorry. So I'm taking out of the determinant. So you get 1 plus a square, so it will become 1, 1, 1, and it will become b square plus 1, b square, c square, c square, c square plus 1. That's how it becomes. So that is equal to, now the continuation of this. The continuation of this is, I will, that is equal to, so again, so moment you make the particular column or a row as 1, 1, 1, then we can make these two as 0 by doing this minus this, R2 minus R1, again R3 minus R1. So we'll apply that operation. So the operation that we are going to apply is, we'll say R2 implies R2 minus R1 and R3 implies R3 minus R1. So if you do this, which is equal to, we'll get 1 plus a square plus b square plus c square, this into determinant of first row, there's no change, 1 b square c square, 1 b square c square, first row no change, second row is r2 minus 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, then b square plus 1 minus b square will give me 1, then c square minus c square is 0. Similarly, this minus is 1 minus 1 is 0, R3 minus R1. Then b square minus b square is again 0. Then c square plus 1 minus c square is 1. So you get 1 plus a square plus b square plus c square into, if you expand this using column 1, you get 1 into this minus this into, which is 1 minus 0. Then other, these two are zeros. So we don't have to write them. So you get 1 into 1 is 1. So 1 into this is 1 plus a square plus b square plus c square, which is your right hand side. Fine. So we have proved the value of this determinant equal to 1 plus a square plus b square plus c square. Right. So what we did, we took first a common from the first row, b from the second row, c from the third row. Then we took again a inside the determinant to the first column, b to the second column, c to the third column. Then it became like this. Then we added the column. So because we add the column, we get the same element in the first column, then take it out of the determinant, then it will become 1, 1, 1. The moment you get 1, 1, 1, then it is easy to make the two of the elements in this column 1 as 0. Then we can easily expand and prove that we get the RHS. Fine. So all of you can pause the video and take the notes. I'll go to the 15th problem. 15th and 16th are MCQs, multiple choice questions. So 15th problem is what? Let A be the square matrix of order 3 cross 3. Then KA, determinant of KA is equal to what? So we know the property that determinant of KA, where K is a number, that is equal to K power N into determinant of A. This is something that result that we should know, where N is the order of A. N is order of A, order of matrix A. Here K is a number, A is a matrix. So K into determinant of KA is equal to K power N into determinant of A. So but here what they have given, K is a square matrix of order 3. So here N is 3. Here n equal to 3. So your determinant of KA will become K power 3 determinant of A, because n is 3. So your answer is option C. So option C is the answer. Fine. So this result is always true. Determinant of KA, where K is what? K is a number, A is a matrix. So determinant of KA is equal to K power N determinant of A, where N is order of A, order of the matrix A. Here the order of the matrix is 3 cross 3, which means N is 3. So substitute N equal to 3 here. So it becomes the determinant of KA. That's what they are asking. What is the determinant of? Then determinant of KA is equal to what? The determinant of KA will be equal to K power 3, because N is 3, which is option C. Now 16th problem, which one of the following is correct? Determinant is a square matrix. First of all, determinant is not a matrix. So option A is out. Then option B is, determinant is a number associated to the matrix. That is true. Determinant is a number associated to a square matrix. That is what is perfectly correct, because determinant is a number associated to a matrix is wrong, because if the matrix is a non-square matrix, then we can't talk about determinant. So B is wrong, but C is correct. Determinant is what? Determinant is a number associated to a square matrix. Okay, that's the definition that I wrote in the beginning of the chapter, right? So if you watch my previous videos, you'll know that. And D, none of this is also wrong, because C is the right answer. So for this also, option is C. What is that? Determinant is a number. Determinant is a number associated to a square matrix. So option C is the right answer. For this also, option C is the right answer. Fine. So all of you can pause the video and take the notes. And this completes exercise 4.2, right? Exercise 4.2. So this completes. So you can watch my next video. So I'm just going away again. You can pause the video, take the notes. So this completes 4.2. All of you can watch my next video for the continuation of this. Thank you for watching. See you all in the next video. Thank you.